Great to have you with us on this edition of the WB Mason postgame. Bob Lorenz, Jack Curry with you in studio. Yankees win game two of the series, 8-0. And Jack, Yankees gave the Red Sox last night a glimmer of hope, but tonight all the glimmer and shine belong to the Yankees and Jay Happ.
Yeah, because Jay Happ just absolutely shut the Red Sox down across 8 glistening innings, struck out 9, didn't walk a batter. And Bob, as I watched him tonight, I thought about the fact that baseball, unlike the other sports, doesn't have a clock. There's always time in baseball. 35 days ago, Jay Happ was a guy who walked to the mound with an ERA of over 10. It was his first start in 11 days. He wasn't happy with the way the Yankees were using him. Do you know who he has been since then? He's been the Yankees' best starter statistically. An ERA of under 2 in his last 6 starts. He has complemented his 4-seam fastball with his 2-seam fastball. And, Bob, he just goes out there and dictates the pace. He is in charge on the mound. And however ornery and angry he was earlier in this year, he's now a guy who is smiling in the dugout and knows that he's going to be a big part of wherever the Yankees go in the postseason.
Anger, happiness, he's channeling something right now. Let's get to John Flaherty and Flash. It's interesting because, J-Hap, this is a great story. You start to get on a roll. Sometimes guys take a step or two back, then they continue. This has been 6 games where he's just been building and building and building towards tonight.
Well, I think obviously Jay Happ has made some changes mechanically. When you watch him pitching, you can tell mechanically he's a lot tighter. His front side is closed a lot better than it was earlier in the year. And because of that, the fastball is jumping out of his hand. But I love the way the Yankees offense came out tonight in the first inning. Urshela, sacrifice fly. Clint Frazier, base hit and RBI. They throw 2 on the board early. And then Jay Happ comes right back in the bottom half of the inning, strikes out the first 2 batters of the game. And this was clearly an example of a bad team, the Boston Red Sox, who got behind to a good team who kept adding on the New York Yankees, and they just put the Red Sox away. A lot of it is Jay Happ, but you also got to give the lineup some credit, especially Clint Frazier had a big night.
Yeah, well,